Three claps, your boy Swain's back. Back at it again, Swain Swaggy Sense. And first and foremost, I want to give a shout out to all my subscribers. We finally hit that 400 subscriber benchmark. You know what I'm saying? Finally hit it. You know, I'm very appreciative of everyone that has been following me through this journey of fragrance collecting and fragrance reviewing and just giving y'all a basic knowledge of, around some fragrances that work, some fragrances that may not work. But ultimately, it's all about smelling good, all right? And that is the purpose for this channel, to bring y'all some information on certain fragrances that may suit you in different scenarios, events, situations, and things of that nature, okay? So just want to shout y'all out, you know, very appreciative once again. So today's video is going to be a tag video, and I was tagged by your boy Goldie Smell Good, you know, formerly known as T Smell Good, but he changed up his title name, but that's either here nor there. But he had tagged me in a video, and the video is going to be based off of a fragrance that matches my vibe, and basically, like, this is me in a bottle. So I have five fragrances that's going to break down what my personality and individuality in terms of each fragrance would mean to me, as well as it shows a part of me, and the scent profile shows a part of me as well. So I'm gonna break that down in this video. So without further ado, let's get into this review. So the first fragrance that I got for y'all is going to be Banana Republic's Tobacco and Tonka Bean. All right, and this is me in a bottle. This is the sweeter fragrance out of the bunch of fragrances that I have. And for me, this fragrance gets compared to Initio's Side Effect. A lot of people say that it doesn't have the same notes, and I haven't really gotten a sample of Initio's Side Effect, but I plan to. But this is just such a delectable fragrance. You have the tonka bean in here, clearly for the name of the bottle. You have some tobacco, sweet tobacco in here, vanilla, plum, pear, some white musk in here as well. This is a phenomenal scent, and I get about 4 to 6 hours with this fragrance when I put this on. That's one thing that doesn't really get that much love because of the longevity, but other than that, the fragrance itself is really, really good. For me, this fragrance is like what I am as far as a personality of a calm person. Very, like, very warm, inviting, cool, calm, collected, nice, but subtle, not too loud. This is a fragrance that is me. So, like, this is the fragrance that I would believe that when I put this on, a lot of people would gravitate towards me because of the fact of my calm, cool, and collected character, and as well as, you know, maybe even a little bit of seduction in this as well. And I can say, you know, I got a little bit of something. You know, I got some game here and there, but
stop it. Get some help.
But the personality within this bottle is just kind of, like I said, I just always refer to, like, calm, warm, cool, you know, and inviting. And, you know, that's the persona that I would give off. All right. So still available in your rack stores. You know, I'm not sure if they raise the price on these discounters online, but if you haven't grabbed the bottle, make sure that you grab this bottle from the Banana Republic line. All right, so that is Tobacco and Tonka Bean. So the next fragrance that I got for y'all is going to be another embodiment of me in a bottle, and that is going to be Rioni EDP. All right, so with this fragrance, this is more so of a classier, more modern, old-fashioned barbershop fragrance. And the reason why I believe this to be, you know, the embodiment of me is I get, you know, recognized as a person that is mature, you know, experienced and wise. And when I smell this, this is for sure something that is in comparison to having all of those qualities. Hence the reason why, you know, wearing this is hands down a confidence booster, as well as smelling the wisdom and the experience and the go-getter type of mentality. Okay, this is an 8 to 10 hour fragrance as far as longevity, and You know, the notes, you have green apple, you have some violet in here, and Broxson. Very ozonic. Have some citrus notes in here for that brightness that happens to come in the beginning. And then after that, it comes down to that floral note. This is great. And once again, this is the embodiment of me. You know, this is something that when I put this on, I feel like I can basically take over the world. I feel like, you know, I'm the one that's in control of my life and also helping others so they don't make the same mistakes. So this is kind of like the experience type of fragrance. And I think that is what I would connect that with my life, with the advice that I would give to others and the wisdom that I would give to others because of the experiences that I've experienced. All right, so that is Rioni EDP. So the next fragrance that I have for y'all is going to be Dior Homme's 2020. And for me, this is the embodiment of like the Swiss Army knife, you know. And I believe that I am that, you know, the man of many hats that can play in any role. This is such a versatile fragrance. Cashmere, ICOE Super. You have some bergamot in here, has some cedar in here, some musk. This is also similar to the Brioni, of like somewhat of that confident and mature and you know, wise type of scent profile, as well as old-fashioned scent profile and I would also say barbershop profile as well. Like, so one in the same, but not the same. But you know, those are some of the notes. But for me, I think that me being able to be put in situations and kind of adapt to a lot of things that happen into your life, I'm good at that. Even though that it might be taxing at times, I think that if you're, you know, at my job, I'm working in one department, but I'm also able to help out in different departments when needed. So like, I think wearing this and having this fragrance, being so like versatile in that Swiss Army knife type of analogy, is for sure something that symbolizes, you know, my character and who I am. So that's what I would think that I would get from this bottle. And this actually might be my scent of the day. I'm not sure. I haven't smelled this in a while. So I get about 6 to 8 hours with this fragrance. Still available, roughly around like maybe like the, depending on the size, maybe like the $70, $70, $60 range, and then on up. But definitely the Swiss Army knife, and that is the embodiment of me. All right, so this is me in the bottle, Dior Homme 2020. So the next fragrance that I got for y'all is going to be Invictus Legend. I've heard that this is pretty hard to come by nowadays. Some people are saying it's discontinued. I even said it was discontinued because I didn't see it, but I just seen samples. But if you can find it for a decent amount of money, then I would suggest you go grab it. But with this fragrance, this is such a different and unique fragrance that smelling this, you know, it has the grapefruit note. It has some sea notes in here, very oceanic type of vibes, sea salt in here. Has the muskiness in here as well, because you don't want to have too much of the citrus, you know, blast to someone's nose, because you'll destroy it because of how strong this is. Because when I wear this, I get about 10 plus hours. It's all day. And this is spring and summer heavy. Like this I don't see this being really worn in the fall or winter. This is more so like spring and summer for sure. And this is a unique and different fragrance. And I believe this is me in the bottle because, you know, I'm different and unique. Like no one is the same. And I think wearing this is definitely something that you will stand out from the crowd, something that no one's going to smell like you. And I think that the way that I carry myself, no one's going to do what I do. No one's going to think the way that I think. Maybe a similar mindset, but no one will ever be able to duplicate that. Neither will y'all. Like, everyone is different in their own way. And I think this is me in my own way, too. So this is a great fragrance, man. I'm hoping that it's really not discontinued. But from what I've heard, like I said, like I'm only seeing samples right now. And when you find full size bottles on eBay or anything like that, they are running the numbers. Okay, so this is Invictus Legend. So the last fragrance that I have for y'all that's going to be me in a bottle is going to be from the House of Dua, and that is going to be Dua's Queen of Spades. And this is going to be their inspiration on Zerjah's Peak of Oyedama. And very expensive bottle. But with this, you get very, very close, if not, you know, maybe identical. This is an old batch. So as you can see, I put a hefty dent in this and I have a backup bottle. But with this fragrance, for me, it's clean. Like when I go out or when I'm going to work or anything like that, like I pride myself on smelling clean, like smelling like I wash myself and, you know, just enjoying the fact on I am put together. And as I'm being put together, it's packaged in a way where it's like the brand new car smell type of deal. But with this fragrance, that's what I would get from this. And this is me in the bottle. Like, would whenever I would go out or whenever I'm going to work, I do get compliments in terms of, oh man, like you're smelling really good, you know, or people would, you know, smell a fragrance in the hallway and they would know that it's me. But, you know, you have these powdery notes, you have some aldehydes in here, bergamot, some other citrus notes, white musk in here. This is, man, like, this is like a baby powder, but very just clean. Like, this is just, if you think of dryer sheets, if you think of like washing clothes and taking clothes out of the dryer with the dryer sheets and stuff like that, ironed them out and everything, and you're about to go out, that, if you can imagine and envision that, that's what you would get from the bottle, and that's what I get from the bottle, and that's why it's me in the bottle, okay? But for me, I get about this all day. This is 10 plus hours, so I can say this all day fragrance for me that lasts on my skin. Okay, this is, you know, all year round. Some of these, once again, you can only pull off, in my opinion, in certain seasons. But this one, you can do okay in all seasons. But you would probably get more benefit out of fall and maybe, you know, like, yeah, fall and spring. Not really too much summer, but yeah, still available. You know, I looked on Dua's website. They still have it. They also do have Queen of Spades Casino Royale, or I believe that has the Baccarat Rouge inspiration in that. But I am okay with this because this smells so fresh, so clean, and so pristine. Just well put together, all right? So that is Queen of Spades. So those are my five fragrances that are me in a bottle, or they match my vibe. And, you know, once again, shout out to the boy, Goldie Smell Good, and the crew that I know that was also tagged in it. So I'm not going to really tag anybody else because they were tagged in the same video. But if anyone wants to be open to doing the tag, you're more than welcome. Yeah, let's see what's your best five in terms of what that fragrance says about you, all right? So don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel. Hit that notification bell just to let you know that your boy is back in action. I'm back home, I was away. Check my community tab, check the shorts, just to let you know when everything's gonna be posted or if anything's gonna be posted, and I'll catch you on the next one. Peace.